Today we're at the Los Lunas Agricultural Science Center in Los Lunas, New Mexico in Valencia County. And we have a demonstration vineyard here. It's also an extension and research vineyard. And today we're going to do several different vines. And I call this situational pruning because, and I think those of you that have done a little pruning will appreciate the fact that every vine is kind of an individual and you have to approach it differently. So today, let's start with just some background of what we're working on. This is a hybrid grape. So it's hybrid between Vitis vinifera and Labrusca. And it's actually, its name is called Enchantment. And it was released out of the breeding program at the University of Arkansas. So it does have some vinifera, but it also has some native grape. So it's more winter hardy than a pure European wine grape. Speaking to that, it has survived our winters here since 2017 in very good shape. And what I will show you here is a couple of dead vines that are pure vinifera vines, and they suffer from crown gall that was initiated by the cold weather that has insulted these vines. Okay, so this is crown gall from two dead vines, Vitis vinifera, the European wine grapes. And you can see, if you look closely, the gall that looks almost like a tumor. And once these galls start to form, they actually choke off the plant's vascular system and it will die from lack of water and nutrients. And so that's caused on a grafted vine at that graft union. Okay? So those vines are both obviously dead. This nice hybrid has survived the winter for two reasons. It's more winter hardy and it wasn't grafted. It's on its own roots. So I'm going to start at the bottom of this plant and prune it upwards. And our goal is to get it to where it'll be trained at about 5 feet. And that's conducive to the growth of the hybrid vines that like to grow procumbently, or hang down, in other words. So we want to train it a little higher, and so it can hang down, and our fruit, consequently, will be here at some point. Okay? So let's start at the bottom and work our way up. Yeah. And once again, just to reiterate, this vine is on its own roots, but we want to train two trunks. Some people don't agree with this, but that I like two trunks. It's called my spare parts theory. So if one vine or one side gets killed for whatever reason, you have the other one. I'm simply removing some of this growth that's come up from the roots as suckers, and I'm getting it out of the way. And when you're pruning, you might want to, instead of just ripping the brush out of the vine area, you may want to make several cuts. I like to use several cuts because if you just make one big cut and rip that whole cane out, you tend to get slapped in the face. And so that's not always a pleasant feeling. So go ahead and make several cuts and save yourself that slight discomfort. So what I'm looking for now, these are the crucial cuts. And what I'm looking for are two strong canes that we can bend up, train up to that 5 foot wire instead of the current about a 4 foot wire. And all of you know that the fruiting wood is this slick wood with non-peeling bark. And that's what we're wanting to use for our new repositioned vine. This was on this trunk, so we don't really need it. Same for that cut. Okay. So we could go up with this guy, train it just about like that, or we could use this stronger one. That's kind of a decision you'll have to make. I'm gonna go with a little bit stronger one, even though it's not as well positioned. That way we can bring it up like this. Okay. So I'm just kind of cleaning it up, making it easier to work with, taking off all these laterals. It's a fairly strong cane. It might even be referred to as a bull cane, but we're going to make use of it. This one's slightly damaged, so we have to be careful on this side. And let's just go with this. Again, bringing it back to center and then go up. So it looks like we've pruned it fairly severely, and we have. So let's go ahead and see how this is going to look. So this will be eventually trained up. It'll come up to about 5 feet. We'll train it horizontally. And the same with this side. And it will be trained up. It'll take a little bit more abuse since it's bigger. And we'll bring it up. And train it horizontally. Okay? We'll come out here and tip it a little bit. And in the, this is January. So in the spring, when I say late winter, early spring, say in March, when the sap starts to run in the vine and these canes are more pliable, that would be a good time to do this training with your extra wire, and they'll bend and tie more easily. All right. One final thing to note, we have the two trunks. They're going to be positioned up to that 5 foot wire, so that's going to be a good deal. And then what we need to do also is spur this third shoot like this. And this is what we call a replacement spur, and it has a bud on it that can grow up and make a replacement trunk in case one of these two fails.